The federal minister of transportation says there is a $10 million offer on the table. It's open to Western provinces affected by Greyhound's closure. Manitoba and Saskatchewan both said no. Federal Minister Mark Garneau says that's disappointing. Garneau first made the offer to Saskatchewan in October and then again at the end of January, saying it was the federal government's hope that any service gaps would be filled by other private sector operators. But there remains a 79% gap within the province. He wrote that without joint support from both the federal and provincial governments, this service gap will remain.
There are some people, vulnerable people, who need to go to places need the bus service, or people who can't afford to drive themselves, or where there is no other form of transportation. We made the blanket offer to all four provinces that we were ready to help, given that situation, while we look for a long-term solution.
There was some talk of this money, but there was no details provided. So it was a very limited amount of money for a very short period of time. With no details. It was offered to five provinces. Nobody's taken it up on it because there are no details on it.
Hargrave says he suggested that Garneau use the money to help private transportation businesses instead. The provincial NDP is criticizing the government for cutting STC in 2017 and for rejecting this offer.
Got a government that's done that, and then Greyhound shuts down. Got fewer cross-country routes, and the federal government comes along and says, we want to have a conversation about this. We want to hear some of what it would cost to get services up and running in Saskatchewan again. And the province just says, no, they're not interested. They don't want to talk about it. That, to me, is extremely weak leadership.
Garneau says the money is on the table until 2020. He says the feds are trying to find a long-term solution to intercity bus travel across the country. Kendall Latimer, CBC News, Regina.